There's a number of different ways people use the word scope, and first I want to explore the simplest of them. The first use of the word scope is lexical scope. This usage of the word describes the regions in your source code where you can refer to a variable by name without getting access errors. The specific rules for this version of scoping can be understood even without running your code, since it only concerns the areas of your code where different variable names will have meaning. Imagine this file held the source code for a very simple program. In simple programs with no functions at all, there is exactly one scope, which is called the global scope. Every variable in such a program would be stored there. We represent the global scope in these slides using the color green. Now, in some JavaScript environments, global scope is shared across different files as a way for any part of the program to interact with any other part. If we add a variable to the program, that variable is said to be in the global scope, and thus it could be accessed from anywhere else in your whole program. Now, we want this program to help us generate stories that are all about the same hero. So let's put this hero variable into the global scope where every other line of code can reference it. Also, for the sake of this example, we should pretend that there exists a function called aHero, and that function returns a randomly generated name. We won't be investigating the source code or the run behavior of that function during this talk. After defining a variable in a lexical scope, you may make reference to that variable from anywhere else in that lexical scope. Global variables are the easiest since there's nowhere in your code that you couldn't access them.